we prepare for the closing ceremony and the medal ceremony.
Hölgyeim és uraim, tisztelettel köszöntöm a 19. FINA világbajnokság záró ceremóniáján a kiemelt meghívottakat, sportolókat és csapataikat, edzőiket, valamint a vendégeket.
Ladies and gentlemen, it is my pleasure to welcome our distinguished guests, athletes and their teams, coaches and all of our guests at the closing ceremony of the 19th FINA World Championships here in Budapest.
Hölgyeim és uraim! Elsőként következzen! Elsőként következzen a magyar himnusz.
Ladies and gentlemen, please rise for the national anthem of Hungary.
Most pedig tekintsük meg közösen, hogyan készültek a szervezők a 19. FINA világbajnokságra.
And now let's watch a video together about the preparations of the 19th FINA World Championships.
Action.
covered a lot of the World Championships. Going back to 2001, this is right up there in terms of preparation, considering there was a very short preparation time. They pulled it off, and it has been a great success.
hölgyeim és uraim, ahogyan arra az esemény, a világbajnokság szlogenje is utal, történelmet írunk. A FINA alapítása óta először a záró ünnepség részeként következik a férfi vízilabda torna eredményhirdetése.
Ladies and gentlemen, we make history. For the very first time in FINA's history, we celebrate the medalists of the Men's Water Polo Championship as part of the closing ceremony.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's time to present the individual awards first.
So before we get to the medal presentation,
for
the three medalists, of course, three teams.
Secretary of the FINA Technical Water Polo Committee.
Victory ceremony platform is ready.
Of the Hungarian Water Polo Federation and Manuel Ebern, chairperson of FINA Technical Water Polo Committee.
All the individual awards handed out before we get to the magic moment for Spain.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's time to announce the top scorer of the 19th FINA World Championship. And he is player number 9 from Team USA.
Yes, the USA.
Alexander Bowen.
Alex Bowen is the leading scorer. 21 goals. Here's what he ended up with. Ended up with a medal. Actually, the Americans slightly disappointing in terms of how they finished as well, but he did pretty much everything he individually could do.
21 goals. 21 goals.
The Spanish might get close to him tonight, the way things were going. So the way things started in Granados, maybe Granados is going to catch him up, but wasn't able to do that ultimately. Granados finishing on 18.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, it's time to find out who was the best goalkeeper.
The goalkeeper of the tournament is not Unai Aguirre. I will be absolutely staggered. But I have been wrong before.
Goes to number one from Spain, Unai Aguirre.
Yeah, Unai Aguirre. There was, let's be honest, very little doubt, was there? Youngest goalie in the tournament turned out to be the best. And my goodness me, what a future this young man has. Not phased, confidence, which spread for miles. Very, very vociferous, very animated. And just learned his craft so quickly in the championship, grew into it. We saw that amazing semi-final performance. He backed it up in the final too.
The World Championship final. Most pedig azonnal kiderül, hogy ki a világbajnokság.
The player of the game in this one. Got to go Granados for him, yeah. I would have thought. I must say go Aguirre, of course.
Is number 10 from Spain, Felipe.
The Gomperoni, okay. Well, he did score two penalties at the end. And it's nice to see a man who's got so much experience. I'm trying to think of different ways to describe him during the course of the event. The old man, the experience. Yeah, old campaigner, whatever you want to call him. I'm sure he's got slightly better descriptive words about himself than I have, but yeah, he was immense, let's face it. Pretty much all the Spanish were. Different players stepped up at different times during the course of the event.
Yes.
Felipe Peroni loving his moment, and he'll love another moment very soon. There's that gold medal placed around his neck. waiting in the wings are the medalists from Greece for the bronze. Italy so close to back-to-back victories. Wang Judah here.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, it is time for the medal ceremony. Hölgyeim és uraim, kezdődik tehát az éremátadó.
Italy will make their way to the far end, to the platform mark two. Closer to us will be Greece, who beat Croatia earlier on today for the bronze. And it has been more than two decades since Spain were able to find their way into the gold medal position. It became a regular thing in the late 90s and early 2000s, but a barren period as far as the top rung is concerned. Italy followed by Spain, and then by Greece.
Ladies and gentlemen, the medals will be presented by Hussein Al-Musallam, the FINA president.
The FINA president will present these awards.
Kyriakos Yiannopoulos,
Musallam,
FINA bureau member. And Fernando Carpeña, FINA bureau member. The gifts will be presented by the two vice presidents of the Hungarian Water Polo Federation, Tomás Molnár and Norbert Madaras. So ladies and gentlemen, finishing third in the 19th FINA World Championships, and therefore bronze medalists are Greece.
So the bronze goes to Greece. Pretty comprehensive winners in the bronze medal game against Croatia early on today.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, let's celebrate our new bronze medalists, Emmanuel Cerveras, Konstantinos Gedinlias, Dimitrios Koupakis, Efstathios Kalogeropoulos, Ioannis Kontulis, Yorgos Dervezis, Stylianos Argyropoulos, Konstantinos Koulis, Konstantinos Karakis, Dimitrios Nikolaidis, Angelos Vlahopoulos, and Panagiotis Tortatos. The head coach of Greece, Theodoros Vlahos.
Ultimately, it was just that narrow defeat by Italy in the semi-final that prevented them from being in this final. 11-10, just on the wrong end of that scoreline, but they were ultimately dominant against Croatia. Put themselves into an 8-5 lead and never look back. Thrilled with their place. Down the Italians will be quite so happy with second. To make the final in what's been a very competitive men's event. By what happened at the Olympics last year, we've turned things around a little bit.
Finishing second.
Shows you what can happen in 12 months. Champions from 2019, and they just about gave themselves a chance of doing it all over again with that late comeback. Three goals down on three occasions in the final. They got it back to level pegging. Spain could not find that late goal, and we went into the penalty shootout, which Drew says is a bit of a lottery, so we've got to score it.
Put your hands together.
One penalty missed in the first five.
Marco Delungo, Francesco Di Fulvio, Luca.
Which came sharply was the Italians who missed the penalty that mattered in the sudden death shootout.
Giacomo Canella, Luca Marziali, Gonzalo Echenique, Nicolas Presciutti, Lorenzo Bruni, e
as well as moments of a lot of sportsmen and women go through where they're desperate to show a smile and try and portray they're happy, but ultimately you are literally a wafer away from the gold. It probably stings more than being beaten quite handily.
And once again, ladies and gentlemen,
so Greece,
Italy.
Third place, Italy second place, and I can tell you the Spanish can't wait. Like they've got ants in their pants. They can't wait to get on that podium. Some already got one foot on it. That's how much they can't wait. And I think overall, everything considered, they weren't beaten all the way through. They were surely, as they proved, ultimately to be the best team. Gold for Spain. So by taking the penalty shootout, they couldn't do it in normal time. They dominated that final. That's sheer exhilaration and jubilance for you. For 10 players who were in that World Championship team in 2019, kind of retribution.
Alvaro Granados, Bernard Sanahuja, Miguel de Toro, Mark Larroque, Martin Famera, Pershing
Cavares, Granados, De Toro, Lurumbe, Cabanas, Tahoe, Peroni, Malarac, Bustos, and Loria. All part of that team in South Korea in 2019, who I think ultimately they will think didn't quite do themselves justice in the final. Well, they more than made up for that in both of their matches against Italy here. 10-5 they were defeated in 2019. 14-12 they beat them in what turned out to be just a kind of dress rehearsal for the final earlier on. Did have such a touch of the final jitters though.
Given
with the three-goal lead being erased. But
here comes the
penalties
trophy.
Came. They were just about good enough to get FINA over the line.
Hussein Al-Musallam. And as the team
will defend their title in Fukuoka
once again
in just over 12 months' time. They've got the European title to go for in just a few weeks' time. Could be world and European champions in a matter of weeks. Spain are the men water polo gold medalists for 2022 at the 19th FINA World Championships, getting revenge for defeat to the Italians in 2019. Selfies are out, the medals are out.
Please rise.
And next it will be the national anthem of Spain. Those celebrations may go on long into the night, and probably when they return to Spain as well. photographers will come in en masse to take snaps of the Italians on the far side, the Spanish in the middle, and Greece, who should not forget, certainly played their part in what was a very entertaining men's water polo competition. So they can prepare. Well, Greece, Italy, and Spain can all prepare for the Europeans coming up very soon. And think about that World Championships in Fukuoka in 12 months' time. Well, the coaches are going to move in now to be amongst their teams. Champions, Champions rings out around this great venue, which has staged the Europeans on three occasions. The Alfred Pajosh National Swimming Stadium has done a brilliant job hosting the World Championships for the artistic swimming and the water polo as well. Of course, there were four different venues for the water polo, all involved.
Az a tradicionális procedúra, ahogy a majd a zászló maga útját járva végül a következő VB szervezőinek kezébe kerül.
És nem felejtsék el, hogy jönnek az
érmeseink. Debrecen, in Sopron and Szeged. The all stage games, but this is the home of water polo in Hungary, and they write that the latter stages should be held here.
Ladies and gentlemen, we still have some in store for you. We will have the medalists of Hungary from the FINA World Championships, and we will have the flag handover. So we still have very important things for the ceremony.
Well, I think I heard them say this could be the presentation of the Hungarian medalists from these games before we conclude. So the closing ceremony stroke medal ceremony has still a ways to go yet. Time to look back over a very exciting day, especially if you are of a Spanish persuasion. 3-3 first period, 3-0 second period. Spain in seemingly cruise control at 6-3. Italy fall back with 3-2 and 3-1 periods. So, I suppose it was inevitable as they shared the periods that we did go to a penalty shootout.
President of FINA, Mr. Hussein Al-Salam.
Now we we're going to hear from the president of FIFA, the closing speech.
Dear friends and colleagues, good evening. We have reached the end of the 19th FINA World Championship. It is always a sad moment when we have to say goodbye to the host city and all of us who have been fortunate enough to spend time here during the past 2 weeks. We'll be particularly sorry to say goodbye to Budapest. Hungary, you are a beautiful capital city, has been the perfect host for the 19th FINA World Championship. The venues have been superb, and the friendly welcome that we have received from the Hungarian people will be remembered for many years to come. So although we are sad to say goodbye, we should be smiling today when we think of all the happy experience that we have shared together during these championships. We can look back at some exceptional individual and team performance by our athletes. We have seen world records broken, a new world championship crowned, and some familiar faces to have been formed champion returning to win more titles. I would like to thank the Hungarian government, the city of Budapest, and the local organizing committee for putting on these world championships at such short notice. We owe you an enormous debt of gratitude. Dear Hungary, thank you for organizing the best FINA World Championship ever in Budapest City 2022. The great news is that we will be back here in 5 years for the 23 FINA World Championship in 2027. So today, we say to Budapest goodbye and thank you, but I am delighted that we can also say Budapest, we will be seeing you again soon. Thank you, Hungary, and thank you for your hospitality and your hard work to make this competition reality today in 2022. Thank you.
I'm sure a lot of people echo those sentiments. It has been a great game, and as he points out, they didn't have a lot of time in which to prepare it. Very little.
Kedves közönségünk, tisztelt vendégeink, most fogadják tisztelettel Vladár Sándort, a moszkvai olimpia bajnokát, a Magyar Úszószövetség elnökét és a 2022-es világbajnokság szervezőbizottságának elnökét.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Mr. Sándor Vladár, Olympic champion of the Moscow Olympics, president of the Hungarian Swimming Association and chairman of the local organizing committee of the 19th FINA World Championships.
Tisztelt Hussein Salam elnök úr, tisztelt Brent Novicki igazgató úr, tisztelt Schmidt Ádám sportfelelős államtitkár úr, tisztelt FINA büró tagok, tisztviselők, kedves sportolók, mélyen tisztelt szurkolók. Ide értünk hát az út végére, amelyről korábban senki sem gondolta, hogy ennyi idő alatt bejárható. FINA világbajnokságot szerveztünk alig 4 hónap alatt. Azt hiszem, a szervezőcsapatunk megcselekedte azt, amit vállaltunk, amit az esemény szlogenje is sugalt, történelmet írunk. Mindezt jó érzéssel tettük, hatalmas hittel és elhivatottsággal, csak is azért, hogy június 17-től mostanáig 192 ország, több ezer sportolójának teremtsünk meg lehetőséget, hogy ők maguk is történelmet írhassanak. És ők éltek a lehetőséggel, hogy csupán FINA históriáját a leglátványosabb új fejezetekkel gazdagító közül említsek néhány történelmet írt Kéti Ledeki, 800 gyorsvonalatot zsinórban 5. győzelmével. Milák Kristóf egyéni világrekordjával. Az amerikai és olasz úszóválogatott sosem látott éremkollekciójával. Az ukrán műúszók két világbajnoki címükkel. Nyílt vízi úszóink első váltóérmükkel. Kínai műugrók minden eddiginél tökéletesebb teljesítményükkel. És legyünk büszkék, nagyon büszkék, női vízilabda válogatottunk VB ezüstérmével. Ezen túlmenően is akadt meg annyi sosem látott kiváló produkció, és még sok a nyilvánosság számára rejtve maradt, de egy sportoló életében történelminek számító teljesítmény. Mindez azért vált lehetővé, mert volt, lett 2022-ben is egy fina világbajnokság. Leginkább azért döntöttünk úgy, hogy belevágunk abba, amiben talán senki más nem merne, mert szervezésben világ legjobbjai között tartanak számon bennünket, mert mi sem tudunk betelni azokkal a mámoros pillanatokkal, amikor Milák Kristóf úszása közben morajlik az aréna, vagy amikor 6000 mobiltelefon lámpásával indul egy sosem látott hullámzás itt a Margit-szigeti estében. Köszönöm a FINA elnökének, Al-Busszalám úrnak, a FINA vezérkar valamennyi tagjának, hogy bíztak bennünk. Köszönöm a magyar kormánynak, hogy nagyvállalásunkat az első pillanattól fogva támogatta. Köszönöm valamennyi közreműködőnek, szervezőnek, önkéntesnek a megfeszített munkát, és külön köszönöm a szurkolóknak, hogy ismét feledhetetlenné varázsolták az elmúlt két hetet. És engedjék meg, hogy megköszönjem, hogy a 19. FINA világbajnokság szervezőbizottságának elnöke lehettem. Életem talán legnagyobb elismerése volt, de ugyanakkor óriási kihívás is. Úgy gondolom, az ember életében csak egyszer adatik meg, és ez a teljesítmény csak a csapatom közel... Köszönöm. És ez a teljesítmény csak a csapatom közel 400 emberének hatékony, emberfeletti munkájával volt megvalósítható. Engedjék meg, hogy sportolóink, csapataink és a sportvezetés előtt álló úthoz sok sikert kívánjak. Még akkor is, ha miénk itt és most véget ért. Mindannyiunk nevében köszönöm a lehetőséget. Hajrá, magyar sport!
Hölgyeim és uraim, most pedig következik a FINA zászlójának levonása, amely hamarosan megkezdi útját Fukuoka felé.
Ladies and gentlemen, please rise to honor the FINA flag, which will soon begin its journey to Fukuoka.
A bronzérmes nyíltvízi úszónk viszi.
Our bronze medalist in open water swimming.
Gálic Péter.
Here goes a parade of the Hungarian medalists from the 2022 World Championships.
Aki már is átadja majd a zászlót, Magyarország ezüstérmes nyílt vízi váltójának tagjainak.
And now the silver medalists in open water swimming national relay have the flag.
Rohás Réka, Olasz Anna, Betlehem Dávid és Rasovszky Kristóf kezén is átment az ászló, amely immáron a női ezüstérmes vízilabda válogatott tagjainak kezében van.
The silver medalist team of water polo.
Kampu Edina, Szilágyi Dorottya, Vályi Vanda, Guri Sattigréta, Máté Zsuzsana, Parks Rebeka, Majő Zseraldin, Keszthelyi Rita, Lejmeter Dóra, Ribánszka Natasa, Faragó Kamilla, Garda Krisztina és végül Magyari Alda is továbbadta az ászlót.
The flag will be passed on to the next hosts, doing it again after what will be 22 years, hosted in 2001, and it will be going to Japan. Should have been this year, but this is beyond everybody's control. It's going to be 2023 for Fukuoka, as Budapest hands the flag on to Fukuoka, Japan, for next year.
He passes it on to the president of FINA, Mr. Hussein Amusalam,
akitől pedig a FINA büró tagja kapja meg.
And eventually lands with the member of FINA bureau, Mr. Daichi Suzuki.
To the conclusion of what has been 16 days of great action. Artistic swimming, diving, swimming, open water and water polo from all the team here in Budapest. We look forward to your company again in Fukuoka next year, and we bid you a fond farewell from Budapest. See you next time.
Hölgyeim és uraim, most a záró ceremónia vége felé következzen az elmúlt hetek legizgalmasabb pillanatairól készült videóösszeállítás.
Ladies and gentlemen, please join us in watching the greatest moments of FINA 2022 World Championships.
Hölgyeim és uraim, kedves vendégeink, a világbajnokság záró ceremóniája ezzel véget ért. Köszönjük, hogy velünk tartottak. Találkozzunk jövőre. Fuku